We continue to tell people that we've only just started. And that's really the truth of where we are. We might have been at this first, actually. We believe we're one of the first to ever deliver a virtual PIN in the world. But the truth is, this market is only just beginning. What is happening now is you're getting a massive buy into what's called a prepaid world. Where the first world countries did it really well is they didn't call it prepaid. The problem with the name prepaid, it's synonymous with a poor man's product. So what the rest of the world did is they called it a cap product or pay as you go. So if you go overseas and look out for it, because it's so noticeable, you'll see how many products in America and UK and Australia and Europe, they call their products pay as you go or capped. It's just a fancy word for prepaid. But when I'm in America, I land at the airport, I buy a $20 cap package. What does it mean? It means that when my $20 is spent, I've got to top it up with another $5 or $10. It's prepaid. So you've got this massive move for it. And why is the future of this product and this world we live in so big? I'm going to summarize it for you into three parts. First of all, you've got the big guys. Call it the municipalities, the telcos, the bus companies, the metros, whoever it may be. They've turned around and said, hang on, guys. You know, we must be silly. Why don't we put more and more product into the prepaid world? One, we get paid upfront for a product we're going to deliver in the future. Secondly, and this is the most important, we have zero bad debts. And thirdly, by the way, we charge everyone a little bit more because we say to them they're not loyal. So there's this massive drive from the big guys doing more and more products in prepaid. You then got the guys in the middle, the merchants. They turn around and they say, hang on, everything else in my store is a physical product. I either bought too much of it, I either bought too little of it, I don't have enough money to stock all the ranges. But in this blue label virtual world, I actually stock nothing. I have a hardware device, I give them a deposit or whatever my payment terms are, and I sit back. First person walks into my store, says, can I have a bus ticket? I hit the button, out comes a bus ticket, collect the money. Next guy comes in, says, oh, can I have a Vodacom 29 rand? Hits it, out comes a 29. Third guy, MTN, fourth guy, train ticket, and so on and so forth. It's the only product in the world, and if you say to yourself, sounds crazy. I stock zero of it, but I sell 100% of it, whatever client wants. Every single thing else in my store, I can assure you there's not one physical product that I'm stocked up 100% all the time to make 100% sale. Yeah, it's a product that I stock zero of, and I strike a sale 100% of the time. Crazy thought. And the third thing, which now brings it all together, is simple. It's the consumer. Consumers don't want surprises anymore at the end of the month. They want to budget their life because, you know, they don't actually mind paying a little bit more to budget, but they can't afford not to. So, you know, you go to anyone on a postpaid contract and say, did you spend your 300 rand for the month? They're going to tell you never. I spent 380 or 450. Did you use the right amount of electricity? Never. I gave my kid a card for the internet and I got a bill for 3,000 rand. I only wanted him to spend 30 rand, right? In a prepaid world, a consumer can budget to the last cent. It's quite an unbelievable thought. If he only wants to spend 300 rand, when the 300 rand runs out, that's it. Doesn't buy anymore. He takes incoming calls. On electricity, it keeps telling him where he is, so he makes sure that he switches off that light and he makes sure he doesn't run the jacuzzi or whatever it may be when he shouldn't be running it. And the kid only gets a prepaid card with 50 rand on it, and that's all he can spend for the month. So there's this massive pull from the consumer saying, I want the product. So bringing it all together, big guy saying, ah, all those good reasons, we're going to put more product in prepaid. Merchant saying, well, this is a no-brainer because I stock none of it. Just give me as much of it as you can. And the thing bringing it together is the consumer who has finally bought into the prepaid world and says, ah, I actually want to live in this world. And more will live in that world. You can bet your life on it. The countries we're in are Mexico, South Africa, India, and Europe. You know, people often ask us, why aren't you in Indonesia? Why aren't you in Asia? We could go anywhere with our product, but it's about focus for us. It's about human resource. We have three massive countries in the face of India, Mexico, and South Africa. So we're really concentrating on them heavily. You know, we've always said we don't want to be a small player. We want to be a big player in a big place. So, you know, for now we have our hands tied. Doesn't mean we can't ever go to other countries. No, all the countries have what we have. It's a matter of when we do it, right timing for us, and of course resource. But for now, very comfortable where we are.